in about 2018, Ford F-150 shifted from the 6-speed 6R80 transmission to the 10-speed automatic transmission 10R80. At first it was for the Raptor only, and then they started introducing it in a simple trims of the Ford F-150. The names of the transmissions are really similar, so 6R80 and 10R80. And you may think, oh, they just took 6R80 transmission and added 4 additional gears, but it's not the case. The problem is that the 6R80 transmission was made by ZF company back in 2000, but the 10R80 transmission was developed by Ford and General Motors in 2017. And they added a lot of new technologies in these transmissions, and they added a lot of things that would cause damage to this transmission. And actually, the 10-speed transmission is not the best thing in the world that Ford did to the buyers of their cars. Now, you can guess it has dozens of software updates, and I strongly recommend you install those updates if you haven't done so before, because every update solved some of the common problems. And if you have the initial software in this transmission, it will have a lot of failures and a lot of problems. In my opinion, one of the major problems with these transmissions is that they have about 12 liters of fluid in them. And when you change the fluid, you will only change 5 or 6 liters. Now, you will have the contaminated old fluid in your transmission, more than a half of that fluid. Now, you may avoid a lot of high mileage problems with these transmissions just by changing the fluid more often. I think 30,000 miles is the optimal interval for changing fluid in these transmissions. But this is not the only problem. So it has problems with software, with TCU, it has problems with the pump. And the pump is actually one of the most common issues. It starts whining, it starts making a lot of noises. And the only way to solve this problem is to change the pump, which is not that cheap. Now, these transmissions shift very harshly from between the gears. And when you shift from R to D, from D to R, it will also be quite harsh. There is nothing you can do. You just need to change the fluid regularly, because this is all about the contaminated fluid, in my opinion. But there are different opinions about the reason of this issue. Now, these are 10-speed transmissions, and whereas the 6-speed transmission would use 4 speeds for the city driving, the 10-speed transmission would use the 7-speed range. And one of the problems with the 10-speed transmission is that it will shift from 5 to 6 to 7 and to 5 again, shift a lot of times. And first of all, it kills the transmission slowly. It kills the clutch plates inside the torque converter. And secondly, it makes it really uncomfortable to drive this car, because it shifts all the time and it shifts harshly and you can feel it. Now, there are also issues when you decelerate. You just let off the gas pedal, you decelerate, and this transmission doesn't know how to shift. There were dozens of software updates, and still Ford can't solve this problem. So it shifts chaotically between the gears and doesn't know what to do. Actually, this feels really bad. But you should also understand that the amount of reports about these transmissions on the internet is really high. So there are a lot of reports from the car owners. But you also need to understand that millions of cars with these transmissions were sold. Only the Ford F-150 trucks were like a million cars with this 10-speed transmission. So a lot of reports are quite natural. And I wouldn't say this is the worst transmission in the world. Yes, it's really bad. It's worse than the 6-speed transmission in all kinds of parameters. Yeah, but it's not the worst transmission in the world. And if you change the fluid once every 30,000 miles, and if you install all the Ford updates, most likely this transmission will survive much longer than it can. But after 100,000 miles, you will still get the problems and will need to repair these transmissions. And sometimes you will even need to replace it, which is not cheap at all.